Thanks for filming it, right?
Yes.
All right, this is our first attempt at our vlog. I've called them vlogs, but my lovely bride has corrected me and said it's a vlog. I'm Boomer. My stage name and pen name is Wildboomer. Not that I'm famous or anything. And basically, we're going to do a vlog that's basically the stuff that we like, or I like. Guitars, motorcycles, guns, cowboy cooking, toddy. Oh, wait a minute. Was that right? Was that my outside voice? Oh, hell. She does good makeup. I don't care. Anyway, really don't know what we're doing here. This is our first attempt at this, so bear with us. We're going to try to put a few of these out each week. Hopefully, I'll be playing in at least one song in each vlog, but we'll see how that goes. It's going to be ever evolving as we figure this out. First off, like I said, this is my guitar. This is the one I like to play on the most. This is my gigging guitar. I am a sometime on again, off again working musician. This is a Gretsch G100 spruce top. They call them jazz box. It has the one single coil floating pickup. It's a pretty neat guitar. Actually, when I bought it, I never dreamed in a million years I would be gigging on it, because I actually was a bass player in a band for many years. But it's the same old story. The lead guitar player falls off into the vodka bottle and never comes back. And after all those years of being in the band, I just didn't want to do another one. So here I am doing my solo act. And I've been doing that for a couple of years now. It's been going pretty good. But anyway, like I said, again, I never dreamed of this being my actual gigging guitar, but I've got a lot of different voices out of it. Anyway, but I'll go ahead and play something for you. When you have a black guitar, there's always that gratuitous artist that you just have to do. So let's see how this goes. Whiskey and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had enough. I wouldn't live to be free. And I hear that whistle blowing, and it tortures me. Here we go. I told you I was a bass player. Just like everything else I do, I know just enough to be dangerous on guitar. So anyway, again, this is a Gretsch G100. This is my favorite guitar. I think I'll kind of stick to the guitar thing today. These are some of my other ones here behind me. Up here, you'll see the Signature Series Gretsch Bo Diddley. I've got a hollow body here, Gretsch, that I've played a lot. This was when I was in a band and I was singing. I'd play rhythm and play that guitar. I've got my Stevie Ray Vaughan edition Fender. I've got a handmade, this 12 string here, actually given to a good friend of mine, by a good friend of mine, Andy Chase, the best working musician in the Amarillo, Texas area. But it's a handmade job out of, I think, Mexico, South America, 12 string. It's called a chinchillo of all things, but it's a really pretty good, cool guitar. Then I got a couple of my basses here. I got about, this is a 78 Gibson Victory, and this is a Cowboy bass, another Gretsch bass, Broadcaster, I believe. I bought it basically to match my guitar. I started playing on that one. Then I got me another Gretsch bass I like better, and that's the one I actually gig on when I'm playing in bands and such. But anyway, you know, we kind of got all this started. I used to write for when I got out of the Air Force.
I love the smell of napalm in the morning.
I was career Air Force and got out. I wrote for several guitar magazines. I mean, excuse me, motorcycle magazines. And I had a pretty successful webpage. And anyway, went back to work after a few years because I got tired of being a starving artist. And anyway, I kind of want to get back into it. My wife has some health issues. I needed to stay home, so I haven't been really gigging, haven't been traveling on a motorcycle that much, and trying to figure out a way to continue doing what we do. She's giving me some sort of signal. What are you trying to tell me, baby?
You still need that creative outlet.
Oh.
You're not writing and all that stuff, so this is another creative outlet.
There you go. My lovely bride says I needed a creative outlet. In other words, something to get me out of her hair. I think, you know, that's what, oops, she just rolled her eyes at me.
That was a silent amen, hallelujah.
A silent amen, hallelujah. So anyway, this was her idea. She's an avid YouTube watcher, and she has all kinds of friends on there, and I've gotten kind of interested in some of them. And this is what we've come up with to do, to experiment with, to either do or die or crash and burn or however we're going to do it. So anyway, we're going to quit filming now and go look on the computer and see how it looks and see how it turns out and see if we're going to keep going or if we're just going to quit.
Happy 23, pause, 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 Freddy.
Tell me.